Let's say I want to manually schedule an art lesson for the 5B grade held by Mr. Sheen. I will drag the card to an empty slot, but the notification panel shows that there are conflicts. Let's find out more and click the error. The view is automatically switched to the teacher's view to show that Mr. Sheen is supposed to teach simultaneously in two different grades. I will also try to remember that Mr. Sheen is a part-time teacher who is not available on Tuesdays and Thursdays. With that in mind, I will return to the classes view to drag the art card to an empty slot on Wednesday. Again, there's a conflict. I will click the error, and the view is automatically switched to the rooms view because the room is already occupied, so I can't double book it. This is becoming increasingly complex and time-consuming, as I have to remember lots of constraints and already scheduled positions and constantly switch between different views. But there is a much better way. Click any card to see its details in the bottom left corner. Then click the icon to show or hide the related extra view. I will add additional teachers and rooms views. To get a clear overall view of the whole timetable, the height of each view can be adjusted by dragging the horizontal splitters. When I click the error, the issue will be shown in the already opened extra view, and when I select a card, it will be shown in all other views as well. Let's now try to find an empty slot for the art lesson. Pay close attention. As I'm dragging the card, the shadow appears in all views, so you can see the forbidden positions, conflicts, and already occupied rooms. That way, I can choose an available slot without having to remember constraints or constantly switch the views. This is so much easier. As you can see, extra views help tremendously with manually scheduling the cards. On a larger screen, you might want to open an individual extra view in a separate window, which can be resized and moved wherever suits you. Let's say I want to keep an eye on a specific teacher's timetable. So I will open an individual view and put it in the bottom right corner. In the individual view, the dragged card will cast a shadow in all other views, so you can find an available time slot. The views are completely interactive, which allows you to draw forbidden positions, pin cards, or even make a selection across the views to perform bulk actions on the selected cards. I will right mouse click the selection, choose Edit Cards, substitute the teacher, and change the room. Finally, let's start the automatic generator to resolve the new constraints. The timetable is valid now. These are just a couple of scenarios, but you can discover more about extra views by experimenting with the app.